الحمد لله نحمده ونستعينه ونستغفره ونتوب إليه ونعوذ بالله من شرور أنفسنا ومن سيئات أعمالنا من يهده الله فلا مضل له ومن يضلل فلا هادي له وأشهد أن لا إله إلا الله ولي الصالحين وأشهد أن محمدا عبده ورسوله فإن أصدق الحديث كتاب الله وأحسن الهدي هدي محمد صلى الله عليه وسلم وشر الأمور محدثاتها وكل محدثة بدعة وكل بدعة ضلالة وكل ضلالة في النار رب اشرح لي صدري ويسر لي أمري واحلل عقدة من لساني يفقه قولي فأوصيكم بتقوى الله عز وجل اتقوا الله فقد فاز المتقون أما بعد Having praised Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and having sent salutation of peace and mercy of Allah upon his beloved Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala be pleased with us always. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala accept our little efforts. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala be pleased with Sahaba, companions of the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, for their efforts and sacrifices. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala connect our hearts. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala inspire us with love, loving one another. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala gather Ummati Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam in Jannah as he gathers ada la ilaha illallah Muhammadur Rasulullah in this world. I advise you and I advise myself that together we should fear Allah. We should be dutiful of our Creator. We should be dutiful of our Sustainer. We should be dutiful of the one who gives us life and is only Allah. We should be dutiful to the one who will soon take us out of this life. We should be dutiful to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala openly and secretly. We should be dutiful to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala remembering and bearing in mind that we are going to stand in front of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala يَوْمَ لَا يَنْفَعُ مَالٌ وَلَا بَنُونَ. When your wealth or your children, your possessions and your all material that you have gathered will avail you nothing إِلَّا مَنْ أَتَى اللَّهَ بِقَلْبٍ سَلِيمٍ, except those who understood the purpose of life, which is submitting their will to the will of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Let us fear Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala in own condition, brothers and sisters. The topic of the khutbah will be as-sidqu ma'allah, truthfulness with Allah, truthfulness with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says in Surah At-Tawbah, this is chapter 9, verse 119. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, يَا أَيُّهَا الَّذِينَ آمَنُوا اتَّقُوا اللَّهَ وَكُونُوا مَعَ الصَّادِقِينَ. That all you who believe, fear Allah. All you who believe, be dutiful to Allah. All you who believe, be conscious of your Creator. وَكُونُوا مَعَ الصَّادِقِينَ, and be together with those who are truthful. Fear Allah and be with those who are truthful. This is a command from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. This is an order. It has to be applied in life. It has to be implemented. Dutifulness to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, and find yourself always in a group of people who are truthful. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says in Surah Al-Ahzab, that is chapter 33, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says in chapter Surah Al-Ahzab, which is chapter 33, verse 70 and 71, يا أيها الذين آمنوا اتقوا الله وقولوا قولا سديدا. Oh, you who believe, be dutiful to your Lord. Fear Allah and speak a word of appropriate justice. قولا سديدا. Be upright in your words, statements that you make, witnesses that you bear, every word, your utterances, be upright, be straightforward, words of appropriate justice. When you speak the truth and you are straight in your talks, يُصْلِحْ لَكُمْ أَعْمَالَكُمْ, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will make for you all your affairs right. He will make your affairs right if you are truthful. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, يُصْلِحْ لَكُمْ أَعْمَالَكُمْ. He will make your affairs and your deeds right. He will accept them. He will sort them out for you. He will solve them. وَيَغْفِرْ لَكُمْ ذُنُوبَكُمْ. And also Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will forgive you your sins. وَمَنْ يُطِعِ اللَّهَ وَرَسُولَهُ فَقَدْ فَازَ فَوْزًا عَظِيمًا. And whosoever obeys Allah and His Messenger, he has indeed succeeded with great success. وَمَنْ يُطِعِ اللَّهَ وَرَسُولَهُ. Whoever speaks the truth, whoever speaks a word of appropriate justice, whoever utters a truthful word, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will make his or her affairs right. Allah will accept his deeds. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will forgive him or her sins. And this is a promise from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala on condition that we are truthful. On condition that we are truthful in words and we are also truthful in deeds. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala praised both believing men and women in Surah Al-Ahzab, chapter 33, verse 35. Inna al-muslimina wal-muslimat, wal-mu'minina wal-mu'minat, wal-qanitina wal-qanitat, wal-sadiqina wal-sadiqat, ila akhir al-ayah. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is mentioning quality of believing men and women, and one of the qualities is those who are truthful men and women. Men and women who are truthful. A'addallahu lahum. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has prepared for them. A'addallahu lahum. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has prepared for them great reward, and Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has prepared for them Jannah. مغفرة وأجرا عظيما. Forgiveness and great reward. End of the verse. Brothers, a believer should be truthful. A Muslim should be truthful in words and also in action. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is the source of truth. He is Al-Haq. And his words, Al-Quran, the message that he inspired Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam with, is also known as the words of truth.